Well, hello everyone, I'm Jenny from BU4U Gaming, and today we are gonna take a look at Spirit Animal Survival. So, this game is developed by True Illusion Software and was just released into early access on the 7th of June 2018, so it is very new still. It is €19.99 on Steam, and it's an open world multiplayer PvP and co-op survival game, but it also has a single player. So the idea here is that your village has been attacked and you have to find and rescue your tribe. So as you can see right down here, the environment is 100 square kilometers, has over 200 plus creatures, 5 instances, 250 craftable items, 4 spirit animal morphs, there will be 11 on full release, and there's a ton of different creatures in the game. You can tame all the dinos and animals that you can ride, fly or swim with, and you can actually also breed them if you have a male and a female. Sounds very nice, right? So, the idea with these spirit animal morphs is that you can actually morph into a spirit animal, and to be able to do this, there are 11, well at the moment only 4 elite monsters that you have to defeat, and each of these will unlock a specific spirit animal ability. And eventually you're gonna need all 11 of these abilities to defeat the evil lord, which is apparently like the end game goal in this game. Okay, so, well, first of all, I wanna say thank you to Patrick, or Mr. Soundwave is his YouTube name, for giving me a key for this game so I can check it out and showcase it to you guys. And he already has several videos on this, and if you try and play this game yourself and you want to check out some tutorial links, you can just click on this link here and that will bring you right to his playlist with tutorial videos. But you can also search for Mr. Soundwave on YouTube if you want to check out his videos. So what do we have here? We have some settings. Let's check this out. So you can change your resolution, you can change whether or not you want to play in full screen or windowed, quality, texture quality, resolution, things like that. Yep, awesome. Let's just say apply. Then there are private servers that you can choose to use. I think with this you're gonna need this information. I guess it's something you're gonna need from someone else if you want to try out there or join their servers, or you can rent a private server yourself if you want to. Then there are here, you can see you can play online, which I'm not gonna do. I'm gonna go for single player as usual, and we'll just have to hope and see that if that's gonna work out. Okay. So we made it to the screen. I actually already did try and record one video of this, but unfortunately my recording software kind of crapped out on me, so we're gonna try and record a new video. But as you can see here, welcome to Spirit Animal Survival. You have multiple options of enjoying the game. One, you can join one of the pre-existing matches using the join button. This will give you a selection of match rooms, including the official dedicated server as well as undedicated player hosted rooms. Okay. Alternatively, you can create your own undedicated match using the host button. Anyone will be able to see and join your room. If you wish to only give select people an ability to join it, you can protect it with a password. This is what I am gonna do. I'm just gonna host my own game. You have the ability to host your own private dedicated server provided for purchase through GTX Gaming. Go back to the main menu and select private server option. Well, we looked at that very shortly. So, that's why you can see actually my name right here. But we're just gonna kind of say new character. And go in here so you guys can see that there's actually this character creation menu. So we have all of these different types of hair that we can choose. What are we gonna go with? Let's see. No. Let's go with that one, and then you can change your skin color. There we go, we have different options. Let's go for this one. You can change your hair color into different variations. It kind of looked blue here, but it is just black hair. There we go, I'm gonna go for that one. You can change your eye colors too. But I'm just gonna go with blue. As far as I can find out, you can't turn her to see her from other sides. At least not with your mouse, and arrow keys don't do anything either. Character name, well, I am just gonna give myself a new name instead of my Yanni name, which is my own name, since I already used that to make the previous video. But let's just choose this one, Raya. It's from a book, actually, a very favorite book series of mine. I read way back when I was, well, both a kid and a teenager, and actually I reread it a few years ago. Anyway, appearance, yes, you can change your body height and stuff. Okay, what does this one do? I actually didn't try this one. Okay, that doesn't do anything. Yeah, I thought maybe this would be like some standard default settings or something. Nope. But of course, you can change your body height and body weight. Wow, you can make yourself tiny. Body weight. There we go. You can kind of play around with all of this if you want to. I'm just gonna leave it like this. And let's say create. There we go. Now it's Raya. Then we can say new character, of course, but then we say host game. And then you have to make a write a match game. And this is the game the name. You'll have to remember this match name. That is how you save your, at least your single player game. You have to write a match name here, and then when you have shut down a game after having played and you want to play again, then to make sure that you enter the same game, you have to write the match name. I saw someone asking about this in the Discord, so I thought I would just mention that is how, apparently, how it's supposed to work. I haven't tried, actually, because I only recorded that one video that kind of failed on me. Okay, password. Yeah, I'm just gonna enter a password. Let's turn off PvP and say create match, because you can actually see here if I type something. And I don't want you guys to be able to join my game. I'm sorry guys, but I'm kind of a lone wolf, and I don't want to have troubles with any any scammers or annoying people who just join the game to trash other people's property and stuff. I've had too many issues with that on official servers in other games, so yep. Okay, so this looks more right. Okay, now we actually have a hotbar, and we have, like you can see in the top left, it says F1, help, F3, keyboard. And I was just sitting here looking at the usage, because my computer doesn't quite meet the recommended requirements for this game. That's why I haven't gone for like the max settings with graphics and stuff, but it's not too bad. I'm using, well, it's using 70%, about 70% of my GPU memory, and only 32% of my CPU, so that's not even bad at all. Well, so far, of course, it might change as we move around and start doing stuff in the game. And the hardest part is actually the memory. I have 8 GB available, and it's using 4.4 of those, and for a while it actually popped up to 6.2 GB. Wow, just by standing here and looking around. So we'll just have to see. But at least we made it into the game now. And if we just hit F1, you get this little thing with tooltips. I do wish they would add them here, so that when you mouse over these, that you would have like a pop-up saying crafting, inventory, and so on. But you can see them in here. The text just kind of needs to be increase the font size a little bit, because it is a little hard to read all of this stuff. I can, but it is kind of small. Tools, weapons, food can be dragged to the lower hotbar, something something. And then you can hit F3 to see your keys. This is something I kind of had to, when I was recording this before, I had to try and get used to. And it registers your mouse movement as you're trying to move around here. But you can see E is your action button, the one you need to eat stuff, pick up stuff. You can P to push to talk if you're playing with other people. Mount a dismount, crouch is C. You can apparently milk animals, I guess. You can feed animals and pets. This one also kind of confused me a little bit. Tab, access, UI, and cursor. But the UI for me, when I think UI, is this. And of course the cursor, which I'm moving around right now. But that's not actually what tab does. Well, not only at least. Then we have activate animal, wings, sprint, jump, yes, 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 follow, stop, tamed pets. Okay, cool. And you can see out here, your right mouse button is for deactivating building pieces and placeables. And left clicking is kind of your general tools, weapons, and everything. So, if you go back out of this, if I say tab, this is what tab does. Tab opens up your crafting and inventory screen, and of course your character screen, which is pretty nice, actually. I do like that you can open this stuff up. I wish, though, that still that all these things had like a key to them instead of having to hit escape to get your cursor, and then you can go down here. And because now I have to go back into F3 to F1 to remind myself what all of these does. But this is kind of your main menu, of course. You can see you can go in here and you can change some stuff around. This one is your character screen. This one is so you can queue up for an arena or something. This one just seems to change the view. So if you click it, it changes which way you're facing. As you can see. There we go. Then we have crafting, we have our inventory, we have... I don't even remember what this does. Alright, social animations and tribe information. I don't have a tribe and I don't know if I actually need one. If you don't like the chat window being this big, you can just kind of click it because I don't need it. I'm alone in here. And then we just hit escape to remove the cursor and get moving. So, if I go up here, it seems like it is permanent where stuff spawns in, because I have the exact same spawns of creatures now as I had when I was recording the previous video. You can see we've got a little troll guy there, and we should have some other creatures over here. So, let's just go and check this out. But I didn't see many creatures, and yeah, currently this is how you get food. There's no like little plants or anything. I hope to see that in the game very soon, because I felt like it seems a little empty when I was walking around in this. Oh, look at that, we got some ogre guy, there's an ant there, and right around over there somewhere there's like a like something that looks like a diplodocus or something, dino. But after that, oh, I actually see something way up there. It looks like there's a village. We should head up that way. Because I am such an explorer, I went out this way and kind of tried to follow the coastline for a long while. I spent half an hour in the game, and after meeting the Diplodocus, I didn't see a single creature. Not at all. And apparently it might be an issue with them spawning in or something, that it takes too long, and that's something they're working on. Unfortunately, they are fortunately for those who like multiplayer, but they're focusing on multiplayer on their servers. So I don't know when that's gonna be fixed here, but I didn't see a single creature at all, and I am just hoping that we'll see some changes to that stuff soon, because it kind of made the world seem a little empty. Well. Very empty, and I really hope to see some of these plants so you can golden apple instead of just picking all of this stuff off the ground. And it would be nice to see eggplant plants, is that what you call them, and cucumber plants and chili plants and whatever else you can pick up. Apparently you're supposed to hit E to drink, but it doesn't seem to actually work, or at least to collect water. But if you just dive in, here we go, come on. And hit E. Then, okay, you have to be under the water. I felt like it did it automatically, it just let me drink before. But I guess we have to hit E actually. And then of course to open my... Let's see what we have here. You can left click if you want to get the tooltip. Fresh drinking water. Oh, nice. I found some of that. That is cool. Then we have some cucumbers. To craft crunchy salad, you'll require 20 cucumbers. I'm just going to put them down there. To craft twisted cedar wine, you'll require red apples and golden apples. Okay. Then there's like a power punch soup. You'll require eggplants, juicy tomatoes, and an oven. And of course, then we have the water. Let's put you down here in case we're away from the water. And I hope we find some other, because there's some other food items that it is only used for eating. So I'd rather save some of these unless we really have to eat, because I would like to craft some stuff with these. Okay, let's try and head over in this direction this time, since I didn't see much on my first trip through the game going out in the other direction. Yes, there's also those strange creatures. Oh, look at that! There's a giant turtle. And that looks like a frog or something. Okay. Well, it to me it seems a little strange, because it is supposed to be kind of the world, like, I think. So like Earth, kind of, that we messed up and killed a lot of stuff and kind of got punished for it, if I remember the story correctly that I read, that is kind of behind this. And somehow we got these spirit animal, or some of us got these spirit animal abilities, and now we're supposed to kind of try and save the world from these big evil monsters. And but it just seems a little bit like a mix-up of creatures, because there's that strange bug over there, and then there's very, you know, Earth-like creatures. Okay, that one is quite big, the frog, but there's like turtles. I saw some elephants at some point too, actually. But then there's dinos, then there's like these strange insect creatures, there's ogres, there's... So yeah, I don't know, I just feel like it's a little bit of a mix match, or just a, you know, just a strange mix of features in the game. And let's see, you just right or left click, and yeah, I hope they're gonna change the text, color of the text, because when you're out here in the sun, it gets a little hard to actually read what you're getting, because the text is white and yellow. It's fairly easy if you're standing in the shadow somewhere, but I do hope they're gonna change that. Or at least give it an outline or something. Oh, I'm actually getting quite bloody now. Do we have enough? We have 11 logs. Yes. Okay, so we should be able to actually make a stone hatchet. Look at that. 4 logs, level 1. Okay, let's craft one of those. Then for a pickaxe, we're gonna need level 2. And as you can see down here, I think this is our level bar, so we're nowhere near level 2. Also gonna need stones and logs. You can craft a torch. We could do that, actually. Log stick, let there be light. Let's wait with that. There's a fishing rod. To use this fishing rod, you have to go out onto the sea on a canoe and find a good fishing spot. Okay, well, let's just craft one, then we have it. There's a thunder torch. Feel the thunder roar from this torch. The fire, not so much. It's a placeable standing torch. We don't really need that yet. Then we have a heavy metal axe. Great for chopping wood and people, but the stone hatchets here you can actually use both for trees and for breaking rocks. And there we go. As you can see, there's a little bar here. So, oh. Okay, that didn't quite work as intended. Give it back. Where did you go? Where did you... It disappeared on me. Okay, we're gonna have to craft a new one, I guess. So don't do that while you're in the crafting menu. Because you can just grab them and place them down on the hotbar, but apparently that didn't quite work as intended. No, it's right there. Then what did I drop on the ground? Did I... Huh? Maybe I picked it up anyway because I was close enough? I don't know. But let's try this again. Please go there. Okay. Did I really place it that far out that it would fall? I don't know. Then we have some cherries. And we have more eggplants. And yeah, this is another thing I hope they're gonna fix. Because if you move stuff from the original area, or the original slot that you have had them in, you can see here I moved the eggplants down here, then any new eggplants will end up in a new slot instead of stacking. But hopefully that is something they're also gonna fix. Then we have this Lime there, we have a fishing rod. Let's just put you down here somewhere. That's a nice thing though, that it doesn't take up the slots in here. Anything you have on your hotbar doesn't take up any slots in your inventory, so this is technically free extra inventory slots. That is very nice. Okay, gathered log, power pair, logs, sticks. Okay, it seems like maybe we get more logs if we're using this over doing things or making... No, okay, we do get other stuff. Okay, that was just me theorizing a little bit. Let's head over here and see if we can get some rocks too. That little rock over there is the one to mine, and you get a ton of different resources from that, currently at least. I don't know if they're planning on adding... Wow, that's right. Different resources, so you'll have... Ooh, is that a raptor or something? I'm not sure. But as you can see here, you get stone, sand, stone, you're gonna give me metal, the gold ore. I don't know if eventually they will make it so that you have different resource types for all of this. Okay, so we have you over there. We have that big... Wow, that's so bright. Okay, let's try and see. Ooh, there's something right up there. Let's go and see if we can check out some of this stuff. It is getting dark, but this the time does move fairly fast in the game. So even though it gets dark, the night passes very, very fast. Which is kind of nice. So you're not stuck in complete darkness for long. Especially when you're doing videos, that can be kind of unfortunate. What are you? Another dino type. Okay, there seems to be more dinos in this area. Then if I followed the way around there, there was like nothing, but there is quite a lot up here, so that is a good thing to see, because I was feeling that the game was very bare bones when I was recording my videos previously, or the previous video. Oh, hello, give me that spicy chili. Awesome. But there's definitely a lot of stuff you can craft, so I'm gonna assume these dudes, if there's any dudes, they're not gonna be aggressive. Okay, and even though I have it on fairly low, wow, look at that, very bright sun, on fairly low graphic settings, it is still... I only have like 16 FPS at the moment, according to Steam. Wow. But it does look quite gorgeous. I do like especially the lighting in the game. I've seen a lot of screenshots that people have taken and left on Steam. But it just needs to be filled out as well. It needs to have more different kinds of plants, because it pretty much looks the same. At least for that half hour I wandered around, it was just more of the same. And it would just be nice to see all kinds of different plants for all these different resources you can collect. And yeah, just generally see some more creatures out in the wild. And that would be kind of cool. Okay, so this might be a reason for us to actually make a torch. Do I have what I need? Yes, let's make a torch. And what do I have here? We have some pears. We got some waving leaves. See, now we have some lucky limes. Let's put you down here. Then I got some gold ore. Nice. I got some metal. Very nice. What is this? We got some sand. That's just got basic resources. Got some stone. And we got some spicy yellow chili. So we have cucumber. Okay. Cool. Aha, and this works pretty nice actually for closing these things down if you use tab for it. Let's just try something else, because I noticed a little issue with this previously. So if I click down here to actually open my crafting menu and click on this stone hatchet, and now I have this little window up here, this tooltip, then if I try to close this down using this one, it doesn't actually close this window down. So I was kind of stuck with this previously, but it helps when you use tab, then you can close that window down if you get that problem. But I hope they'll fix it so that even using these icons down here will still close down all the relevant windows. That would be really nice. Okay, but I am happy that we can use tab, because at first I was like, oh, am I stuck having to do this? Because I wanted to use, like, you know, something for crafting, I or B for opening inventory and things like that. But when I found out you can actually use tab for it, oh, that's nice. Because having to hit escape all the time and go down here and click again and escape to exit, oh, nope, that's not for me. So, did we get the torch? We got the torch. Okay, let's put you here. And see. Oh, nice. Okay, it gives us a very nice light, actually. That is cool. But, as you can see, the sun is actually already coming up again. But let's just try and head over here and see what we might find. There's definitely some peeps here. Are they like bad peeps? Are you gonna attack me or something? Oh, you are gonna attack me. Oh, I should have made some kind of weapon. Okay, let's just try and see if we can run away from this dude. I don't know if they're gonna follow me for like forever or what. No. Okay, it seems like he gave up. That is good at least. So let's see, can I make a weapon? What about a wooden spear? We need more sticks for that. What about the bow? We need a rustic rope. Can I make one of those? No, I need cotton. Oh, bummer. I haven't found any cotton yet. Not in this little place over here. But we can cut down some more trees. Where did that dude go? Did he run back to the village? I guess he did. Okay, so this is more like a goblin village or something like that. I don't know what that dude was, but it made me think of goblins. This, and yeah, if you die, apparently I think all your items get dropped on the ground. I haven't watched any videos. I'm sorry, Patrick, I haven't watched your tutorial videos yet anyway. Because I do prefer to jump into a game as blind as possible to, you know, get an idea of how intuitive it is when you don't really know anything. But they do have a Discord for the game, and they are very active in there, both the developers and all the players, or a lot of the players who play this game. So that's definitely a good place to join if you are interested in the game, if you play it yourself or if you are interested in the development. That's always, Discord is just a handy tool for this stuff. But I have seen people kind of talk about things in there. And let's see, can I make anything now? Rustic, no, I still need the cotton, but if I could make a spear? Yes. So apparently all your items will get dropped on the ground if you die, and you, if you don't have a bed or anything placed, then we will just have to will spawn in randomly somewhere in the world. But as you can see, there's all these different things you can craft, all these building items, roof, foundations, stairs, walls, doors, overlaps. Okay, so there's a ton of stuff to play around with. As far as I know or have heard, you can't actually remove these again. At least that's what I read in the Discord one day, but I don't know if they have changed that in the meantime. There's been a few updates lately, and I haven't really read through them because I haven't played the game myself, so I don't really know what all this stuff means. Oh, I'm forgetting to eat something. Okay, well, let's just go in here and use. There we go. Now we're just eating and use. Cool. You down there. Let's put you down there. There we go. That should be fine. What about this? Restore some health. Awesome. What do you do? Restores thirst. Oh, that's nice. Should actually look at what these things do. 15 to 20 thirst, thirst, thirst. Okay, you don't restore that much thirst compared to hunger, so let's eat you. Nice. And what do you do? More thirst than hunger. Okay, let's eat one more. Aha, we are good now. Awesome. And we got a spear. Oh, stop it. It does that fairly easily. It just kind of, oh, come on. Gets strapped instead of going into the slot. So You know, did it again. Stop it. Okay, let's move you over here and let's put you. Please go in the slot. Thank you. Nice. Well, now we have a spear, so I don't know if this is gonna be enough, but let's just go and see if we can deal with one of these. Oh, look at that big dino over there. It looks like a Kano or something. Carnosaurus, I guess it's called. It's used to playing Ark. Come on. Come here. Come here. Can I just deal with one of you? There we go. Okay, you're level 6, so this might be bad. Okay. Okay, that didn't work. I died. So left clicking with a spear doesn't do anything. We only have to use right click first. Okay, so let's see what happens. Okay, so it looks like I spawned in where we started out before, actually. And, oh, there we go. Just a little slow reaction, but there is the T-Rex or whatever. And yeah, we lost everything, even what we had on our slot bar or hot bar. So let's just try and go back over here. And from what I saw someone complain about that in the Discord, or at least suggest that it was different, that you got to keep your stuff or something like that. I kind of just was looking through the form a little bit in there, and I just noticed they said that's not gonna change. They do want it to be, you know, so it feels like punishment when you die, so it is gonna be a thing that you're gonna drop all your stuff when you die. And the thing is, we're kind of, I should probably have backed up a little bit since I knew that instead of dying in the middle of that village. Okay, we're running out of stamina a little bit, but let's try and go over there and see if we can get some of our stuff back. Like this. Here we go. Like that. Green apple, nice. Okay. And I see all my stuff. That's the thing. No idea. Why did I die? I died right around here, didn't I? At least from what I know, it should have kind of dropped all my stuff on the ground. But I do see a little bit of stuff right there, but I did have quite a lot of stuff on me, so. Okay, we're just gonna try and go over here. And oh, I got an achievement. Be careful, you died here before. Yes, I know. Don't hatch it. Thing is that, oh, give me the cucumber. The hitboxes are a little wonky. On stuff, so it can be a little hard to pick everything up. Okay, he went back, so I can go this way around. I know there's one to the right too. Ooh. What is this? Oh wow, it gets spread like all over the place. Cherries. Okay, what did I get? Oh. What is this? Iron spear, slightly more powerful than... Okay, well I got some stuff that I didn't actually have before. That's kind of handy. Well, there is my axe, and there is my torch. I'm still missing my fishing pole and some of the food items. But yeah, he was level 6, so it wasn't actually, isn't actually that surprising. Can I pick this up? No? That's not mine? Just a stump in the ground. That he beat me. Oh, got some stuff here. Logs, sand. Nothing in there. Okay, he's over there. Can I see more? Oh, see something here. Give me. Those are my golden apples. Oh, crap. Ooh. Run. Oh, he gave up pretty fast. Which I suspect might be something they're gonna change in the future to make it even harder, because right now it's pretty easy to run away from them. Okay, well, we got some stuff. Let's just back up a little bit and check. We got the iron spears. We got all these little... Oh, come on, food items. Oh, my apples, these. I just like to sort out my inventory a little bit every now and then. And then we have all this like metal related stuff. We have general resources. Let's see, we have some extra tools down here. That's pretty nice. I'm still not seeing my fishing pole. I would like to get my fishing pole back. Oh, he's gonna come for me again now. Yep. Oh, run. Oh, no. Go away. Aha. I wanted to see if I could get my stuff back. If I run around, can I find it? Can I find it? Oh crap, there was another one. Ouch. Okay, it might not be worth it. Let's ignore these guys. I think we need to level up some more before we try and deal with those. Ouch, okay. Well, we've got a dino over there. And how are we doing? We do have some logs. Weapons, wooden bow. Oh right, I needed rustic rope, and for that I needed the cotton, right? So yeah, if I want to, well, we should probably see if we can find a place to settle down a little bit. As you can see, there's a lot of buildings. That's like pre-built areas, storage shed. Keep your guy a good dry with the shed. That might be handy. But I need some animal fat for that though. Double pose, Tacoma, adobe house. Add your own personal touches to make this home extra cozy. Level 15. Wow. This shack is stackable, makes a great place for storage on misbehaving tribe members. Level 5. So they both have all these like pre-made buildings that you can see. You can see here, land house. This two-story house provides lots of space for growing families. I don't know where to get clay actually. We could make clay. I think we could make clay actually. There's a dockyard. This dockyard works best when placed in water. Ah, that makes me think I want to build somewhere close to the water actually. There's like a jungle lookout. There's all kinds of stuff in here that you can craft and play around with. Pewter tankard. Keep your ales cool and frothy in this tankard. Cheers. But on the other hand, you can also try and build your own stuff. But from what I know, you can't remove these pieces, which is a little sad. I hope they're gonna change that soon. Okay, we don't need a spear now. I need to find some cotton. Okay, let's see. But it does seem like everything right now, all these area or all these POIs, as you can see on the compass, they all seem to be kind of in the same area of the map so far. So we have the all-seeing eye. What is this one? Yenalusi werewolf cave. I'm not sure we're ready for that yet. Grawls settlement. Okay, so they're Grawls, I guess. And the all-seeing eye, I have no idea what that is. Below, I don't know what that is. 919, we're just gonna go and check it out. And these, it doesn't say anything. Okay, well, I think we're gonna try and go for that bigger thing. I wanna see what that is. 900. Wow. 900 meters. That's quite a far away. Can I actually see anything? The light is almost too bright. Is that just me? I feel like it's a little too bright. I do kind of like the lighting, but I feel like it kind of disturbs my eyes a bit that it's kind of very bright, the sunlight. It would be cool if we could change that. Okay, we have you down there. I'm not sure we want to try and deal with you just yet. We're gonna need to have to try and place something down somewhere and build a bed or something. Okay, so my axe is almost broken. I've just been grinding a few resources, and these are the actual cotton that we needed. You just have to find the... There we go. Nice, the hitbox, and then we got some cotton, and these tipsy turnips exactly what I was looking for when it comes to some food, because they don't have any other use. It tastes better than it looks. It's not for cooking or anything, and it restores hunger as well as a little bit of thirst. Though, let's just put you down here. Oh, it does that a lot when you try to put stuff down. Come back. Give me my turnips back. Give me back. Thank you. Put you right there. Thank you. Nice. And I was just grinding some resources. As you can see, I got some copper ore. I got more gold ore. Let's put you in there. We got some silver ore. Nice. Got quite a lot of these, actually. 86 metal. Nice. Look at that. We got some cotton. I got more of these. Got some red apples, too, now. And what are these? Poison plum. To craft Kiss of Death tonic, you'll require poison plums and rotten meat. Okay, I'm just gonna put them down here, though, even though we don't want to eat them. But it's just... all of this is something that you can use to craft something. Well, food or, well, other stuff. There we go. Let's put you over here. So, what do we need? We needed a rustic rope. Yep, we need cotton logs level for that. Let's craft that. And... okay, what do I need for clay? For clay, I need sand and water. Okay, so how do I get water? Like, we have these, but... oh no, I don't have them anymore. I didn't find them again. We had some water. Is there a way to carry water? Like, okay, if we say search. Water catcher. Okay, decorative item. Does that mean it doesn't actually catch any water? Or you know, have water, a decorative pitcher? Okay, well, that's not really what I wanted. Anvil, storage den, a coma base. How do I get water? Basket of fish. This will be a tasty treat. Okay, small storage. We're gonna need this. For that, we're gonna need 20 logs and level 2. So we need to actually reach level 2 before we can even put down a storage. Loaded kitchen storage. Oh, storage crate. These are decorative and provide storage. Nice. Platform. Works well in water and on land. Okay. Haystack, pail, fishnet, trunk. Lookout bridge. With the other bridge building pieces. It may also be useful to use when crossing smaller streams. Nice. I can see that you can go quite crazy with the crafting and the like decorative building stuff in here. Lockbox. This closed locked box will keep your belongings extra safe and secure. Okay. Double door, stairs, rubber fortress, bike defender, lookout, ladder, wooden barrel, decorative and useful. Okay. Furnace. Furnace with bellows, useful when crafting tools and recipes. Active melter, will be needed when crafting tools and weapons. Small veggie, you have such a green thumb, enjoy your harvest. Oh cool, small veggie garden and medium. Oh, I do like that. I still hope we're gonna see more of these plants in the nature, but, instead of this just picking it up off the ground. But I do like that we can apparently grow some stuff. The sailboat allows access to the tribal lands. Okay, interesting. Oh, there's a horse wagon. Long rides into the promised land can only be mastered with a horse wagon like this. There's a lot of stuff to dive into here. There's some boards, and we have all this armor. Okay, what if I want to make a helmet? I'm gonna need jungle silk for that. What about this one? Leather and cloth, leather cloth. Well, I think I can make cloth from the cotton. See. Go up here. Yep, I thought I saw something. Created by mixing cotton and water together. Which doesn't actually... it doesn't actually require water. So I'm not quite sure what the deal is with that, because it requires logs. I don't know if that's a mistake or just a temporary solution or something. But we can craft some cotton or some cloth if we want to. And let's just do that. Let's make some of these. Nice. Then we have spices. Garlic and spicy red. Oh, campfire. Great for cooking, but keep you warm at night. Okay, anvil. What do we need for that? Stone and metal. We can actually do that, but we need level 5. Okay, basic. Where's the bed? I want a bed. Where's the bed? There's no bed. There's supposed to be a bed or something that you can place down. Equipment? Just my gear, right? Weapons? Yep, and tools. Of course, buildings. Is there a bed in here? No. Yeah, the search function doesn't seem to work in here. I tried this previously when I was just looking for a foundation, for instance, but it doesn't do anything. It seems to only work in the other menus and not in this one. Let's see. Roof. Nope, not seeing anything. Thank God, week. I don't know if we need to craft something else before we can craft a bed or something. Storage pod. Okay, well, I looked through this and I don't seem to find a bed at all, so I'm not quite sure what. How are we supposed to do that? I know there's supposed to be a bed that you can place down, but I'm not sure which. It would be nice to have a menu up here that just said something like crafting stations or something, because it is a lot of stuff to look through this to find whatever you can, like, do. Okay. Yeah. I don't know. I can't find a bed. And I didn't see anything called, like, a workbench or something, which is actually also what I was looking for. In case we needed that to actually make... Oh, maybe it's a cart. Aha! You'll have a nice sore bag in the morning after sleeping on this rustic cart. So we would need cloth and logs. Level 5. What about this? Oh, this one. Basic yet comfy. 10 logs and 1 cloth. Ooh, we're gonna craft one of these. I assume this is the bed, actually, the cot. I was kind of looking for a, you know, bed of some kind. This is a bed. It's just a basic bed. Yay! Well, we found that. And then we would... Did I not craft it? Where did it go? Oh, it's right there. Then we would need to... I wish that it would work with the... search in here, but it just doesn't. Because there's a lot of stuff to look through when you want to do something here. Ooh! Come on! There's wood! I just want... Okay, foundation branches. Basic foundation for branch houses. Basic round foundation for branch houses. Okay, we're gonna... Can I do... Okay. Why can I not do anything? Oh! What now? Ooh! Oh, okay, this is kind of very delayed. Oh, we're just gonna try this. That this is not actually where I want to live, but let's just test it out. And then we'll do something else in the next one, or we'll go somewhere else and build something. You don't have all the required materials. Lock 4, stick 15. Ah, okay. They should just make it red. Maybe we should make it glow red when you don't have everything you need, or have some kind of indication in here. 4 times log, 15 sticks. Well, I have 19 sticks. And... Oh, I used up all my logs. Okay, I'm just gonna get some logs and then we're gonna try this out. Okay, I think I have what I need. Yeah, we are just gonna try this out. As far as I know, we can't remove it again. But hey-ho, it's not that these resources are that expensive. So, if we go into building and basic foundation for branch houses, okay, I clicked it. Are you gonna let it pop up so I can actually build it? Come on. Click. Double click. Oh, I didn't even mean to do that. Oh, wow. That is so delayed when you're trying to do that. It just takes forever. Okay, well now we have a little foundation here. Interesting. It doesn't seem like one way this is supposed to be the floor. Okay. Easy. Whoops. E to eat. And then you have to wait a little bit. There's like a little pause. You can't just spam eat. And now I have to wait a little bit again, but let's just go out here and get something to drink. Nice. And then you hit E again. Come on. Okay, now I have to wait a little bit. Come on. Come on. Eat, eat, eat. Okay, it won't let me eat now. Okay, if I hit 8, 7, something, 9 again, and say E. There we go. Now you let me eat. But yeah, it doesn't really look like this is supposed to be like the floor of a house. It more looks like it is just a foundation to build an actual house on. But we do have this. So how do I place you? Do I have to put you down here? No, I can see it say drop. Ah, stop it. Stop it. Give me that back. Okay, let's try again. Can I put you on the hotbar? Yes, I can. Okay, then I have 5. Nice. I probably didn't even have to do that. I could just have placed it out here, but I'm just being stubborn. There we go. Let's do that. Left click. Aha, now we have a card here. Nice. So if I hit E, no, F, E, F, something. So you can't actively sleep on it. Well, now we have it, so we'll just have to see next time we die if we're gonna end up back here or not, because it doesn't seem to do anything. No, F3, come on, that's F2. F2, yeah, F2 kind of removes the UI if you want to take some pretty screenshots. There we go. Down, move, remove. And to F3. I'm just hitting the wrong keys here. There we go. Action. Blah, blah, blah. No. Doesn't say anything about sleeping. Okay. Well, I assume we're gonna end up back here when we die. And then, of course, we'll have to go and get all our stuff again. But, yeah, there's also no apparently reason to remove this stuff. What if I hit it? And I, like... Okay. I know, I kind of just built it. I just want to see if I can actually destroy it or pick it up again or do something. I do seem to be damaging something, but... No. Doesn't really seem to do anything. Or it just has very, very high health points. Okay, well, we kind of got started, guys. This is all we're gonna do today. I am gonna make another video, I think, where we're gonna go and see if we can explore some of these other things. Oh, it was actually 8,000. In my head, I read it as 900 or something away, that building up there on the toolbar. But it actually says 8,000. Wow. Okay, that's pretty far away, actually. And 5,000... Okay, what about that all-seeing eye? 8,000? Ow. And 4,000. Okay. Well, we will just have to check this out some more in the next video. And yeah, if you already play the game, let me know what you think about it and how it's going for you. And what's your favorite part about it. And yeah, just let me know how you feel about it. And well, if you don't play it, just let me know what you thought about the video and of what I have shown you so far. Yeah, thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming.